Welcome to the top five sports callers of the week. Number five.
Jesse from Mansfield, Texas, joined the Dallas Cowboys postgame show on 105.3 The Fan in Dallas with his thoughts on the Cowboys and their defensive coordinator.
Well, first of all, I want to say it was a heck of a game. You know, it's great to be a Cowboys fan. You don't know whether to be happy, sad, excited, mad, but it was a good game. We had a good defense going on. Romanelli, he's got a great defense right now. I just want to say Brandon Whedon, I think he can hold us up for these next five, six games, you know, with the bye. I think we can make things happen.
Appreciate the call, Jesse. That was good stuff, man. I like your optimism, and I like the invention of a combo named Romanelli. Sounds like that'd be a hell of an American to me.
Number four.
Brandon from Atlanta hopped on with Rick and Jamie on 92.9 The Game in Atlanta because he thinks Georgia fans are delusional about the team's chances against Alabama.
But the teeth of that Alabama front seven can and will stop Nick Chubb, and these delusional Georgia fans that think because they beat probably a four-win South Carolina team that they're just going to trounce over Alabama and Ole Miss have got something else coming, and they better wake up because Bama is coming to town. They all off, and they're going to give you a piece of it.
I love it. Wow. Brandon is all hot and bothered. Here on a Gut Check Monday.
Wow.
On the Rick and Jamie Show. Brandon, we love you, man. He's one of the Rick and Jamie All-Stars.
Number three.
Darren from New York joined Boomer and Carton on WFAN in New York to talk about Yankees legend Yogi Berra.
The man was 90 years old. I'm 40.
Right.
He was 50 when I was born.
I understand the math.
And I'm more hurt today than I am when my father died.
Oh, stop. You're embarrassing yourself.
No. I'm not embarrassing anybody but you right now, Craig.
No, come on. Stop. It's nonsense.
Yeah, come on. The life this man led. You're going to tell me? Come on, man.
I'm saying
and your producers are laughing.
That's right. He should laugh at you. It's ridiculous what you just said.
Okay. What's ridiculous is that I want to talk about Yogi Berra, and his answer to me was he was 90. What? What do you mean, what?
Go ahead. Well, I'm giving you a chance to talk about Yogi Berra. What do you want to say? Yogi Berra passing away, which is a terribly sad story, and you have to remember a great life and an accomplished life and a wonderful man means more to you emotionally than your father dying?
Yes.
Number two.
Michael from Chicago called in to Boers and Bernstein on 670 The Score in Chicago to tell the guys he'd rather learn about dung beetles than watch the Bears.
Hey, you know, Terry, you were talking earlier about, a bunch more stuff being more interesting than the Bears game.
Mm-hmm.
You were correct because the wife and I, after we bolted from the game, we bounced back and forth from Antique Roadshow and some Hispanic nature program on the dung beetle. It was much more interesting.
Is it a Hispanic nature show?
Yeah, we don't even speak Spanish, but you see a big wad of crap being pushed around by a insect resembling a beetle. You put two and two together.
It's Ringo.
It was very much more interesting than the Bears game.
There you go.
I think it's a
solution. The Antique Roadshow and the Hispanic dung beetle. I don't know what he's talking
and
about.
And members of Hispanic dung beetle.
Number one.
The top spot goes to Mark from Philly, who called in to Angelo Cataldi and the morning team on 94 WIP to express his displeasure with Chip Kelly. He thinks Kelly is setting the team back 11 years.
We don't have anybody. He's going to set our franchise back another 11 years. We haven't been. We were there 2004. Andy Reid at least took us to the top. This guy is going to set us back another 11 years. Man, we're trying to win. We're not going to win with this guy. He doesn't believe in running the ball north and south. You said you got rid of LeSean McCoy because he wouldn't hit the holes in the A and B gap. Why are you running zone outside rushes? You're going outside. Give it to DeMarco Murray and let him go up the A and B gap. You're supposed to be a coach. Give it to him. Let him go up the middle. Man, we take our money every year. We watch this team and follow them, and we can't get it done. We never get it done. Never.
Mark,
come on, man.
Mark.
It's done.
Mark, exceptional. I have nothing to add. You were brilliant.
Tune in every week to hear the wildest callers and the wittiest banter as CBS Local Sports brings you the top five sports callers of the week.